Hello everyone, welcome back to this video on digital communication. In this video, I am going to talk about the performance analysis of digital communication system. So I have already talked about the various types of noise and additive white Gaussian noise as well. So now I hope you have seen those videos. If not, I recommend you to watch those videos first. In this video, I am going to talk about the optimum linear detector for binary polar signaling. So if I talk about the binary polar signaling, in binary polar signaling, 0 is represented by minus xt and 1 is represented by xt. So this is my binary polar signaling. So I hope you all remember what is binary polar signaling. So if I transmit it, so it is represented as plus minus xt. So when I transmit it, there would be noise in the channel. So this noise would be added to the signal and this is received by the receiver. So the yt is received by the receiver, which is plus minus xt plus nt. So if I talk about the diagram of the receiver, so here it is my plus minus xt, which is added to the nt, and now it is going to the receiver, which has the transfer function hf or ht. So if I talk about the frequency domain, it is hf, and if I talk about the time domain, it is ht. So now this is yt. So this is yt, which is plus minus xt plus nt. So now here, after this receiver, I have a switch. So this is my switch. So now this is my switch, which is helping me in the sampling of the signal which is received. So I need the digital signal. For that, the sampling is required, and with the help of this switch, the sampling would be done. And after the sampling, there is a threshold device. I already told you what is the working of the threshold device. So if I talk about the threshold device, it just detects the amplitude of the received signals. So if the amplitude is positive, it says it's 1. If the amplitude is negative, it says it's 0. So threshold device is actually converting the signal into 1 and 0 form. So now I hope you remember what is the working of threshold device. So if I talk about the linear detector, so this is the formula, this is the diagram of the linear receiver. So if I talk about linear receivers in our course, I'll be talking about 4 types of linear receivers. First is integrate and dump filter or receiver. Actually, what happens, the receiver is working like a filter only. That's why I called it as filter. So firstly, I'll be talking about integrate and dump filter. After that, I'll be talking about optimum filter or receiver. After that, I'll be talking about matched filter, which is really important. In competition exams also, a lot of questions come from this domain. So now after that, I'll be talking about correlator and coherent receiver. I hope you remember what is coherent receiver. We'll be talking about the probability of error of all the coherent receivers we have talked before, like ASK, PSK, FSK. These all were coherent receivers. In these coherent receivers, there is some probability of errors at the output. So we'll be talking about the probability of errors of all the coherent receivers. So now coming to the binary polar signaling. So I hope you understand what is binary signaling. I have already told you, but here in this section, I am going to talk about the noise which is adding to my signal. So now when noise is added to the signal gets contaminated. So now, so if I talk about the noise, the amplitude and the characteristics of the noise will determine the occurrence of the error. So firstly, I'll be talking about the characteristics of the noise. So if I think that my noise is any type of random noise, so that would not be possible in the receiver. So mostly the noise is the additive white Gaussian noise. I have already told you that in my previous video when I was talking about the additive white Gaussian noise. So mostly the noise which are coming to the receivers are additive white Gaussian noise. So we'll be taking the characteristics of the noise to be following the Gaussian PDF. I already told you in additive white Gaussian noise, the PDF was Gaussian. If I talk about the power spectral density, that was constant and not by two. But if I talk about the PDF was Gaussian. So here also we are taking the assumption that all of the noise which is coming is additive white Gaussian noise or which is having the Gaussian distribution. So if I talk about the distribution of the noise, it would be equal to 1 upon sigma root 2 pi e raised to power minus mu square upon 2 sigma square. So where my mean is equal to 0 and sigma square is my variance. So this is the characteristics of the noise. So if I add this noise, so these are my three Gaussian noise. So this is the mean. So I am taking three Gaussian noise with different sigma. So this is sigma 1, this is sigma 2, and this is sigma 3. So now I hope you remember what is sigma. Sigma is the spread of the signal. So I can say sigma 1 is less than sigma 2, which is less than sigma 3. So now if I talk about this noise would contaminate the signal mostly at this point. So at mu, this and sigma 1 noise would mostly contaminate the signal. But if I talk about sigma 2 would contaminate somewhat less because its amplitude is less at mu. So if I talk about sigma 3, it is very less contaminating my signal. So if I talk about all of them combined, all of them are contaminating my signal mostly at mu. So now if I talk about the binary polar signaling, so if I see this is my message signal. So this is my message signal. Let's suppose this is my message signal and now there would be some noise which is added to this signal. So this is the noise. So I hope you can see at particular instance these are following the Gaussian distribution. So I can say that now because of this noise the amplitude would be shifting. So if this is added with this, so it is like this. So after here it would be added from here, and now after here it would be added from upside. So now this is the type of signal which I'll receive. So I'll denote the signal again. So it is like this. So this is the signal which is received. So the black one is the transmitted signal. This is the transmitted signal. Green is the noise. And if I talk about this blue part, this is the received signal, which is plus minus xt plus nt. So now if you see here what is happening at the receiver, it would be sampling at some particular instant of time. So let's suppose it's sampling at these points. So now when it samples at these points, after sampling, what is there? Threshold device. The threshold device will measure that it is greater than 0 or less than 0. Here the output would be greater than 0. Output was positive, so there would be no error. Here also the output is greater than 0. Output was greater than 0. No error. Here the output was lesser than 0. It was lesser than 0 also. So no error. It was also correct. But here when I see it, it is greater than 0. But actually the signal transmitted was 0. So the receiver would say it is 1. But actually what was transmitted? The transmitted signal was 0. So here I'll be saying error would be there. So here the error would be there. So after that, at every instant it is greater than 0, and actually also it was greater than 0, so it will say it is 1, and it was actually 1 also, so there would be no error. So actually error was induced here only. And why it was induced? Due to the amplitude of noise. So I said there are two parameters which is determining the noise. So determining the error due to noise, first is the characteristic of the noise. So the characteristic is that it is Gaussian. And after that, the second parameter is the amplitude of the noise. So I already told you how the amplitude of the noise is disturbing my signal and producing error at the receiver. So if I talk about the two Gaussian signals. So if this is my signal whose mean is at minus a by 2, and this is my signal whose mean is a by 2. So the error would be caused by minus a by 2 in this part. So this is the distribution of minus a by 2, but it is coming in the a by 2 distribution as well. Similarly, it is of my a by 2 and it is coming into minus a by 2. So if I talk about the probability of error, so it is given by probability of occurrence of probability of minus a by 2, when probability of minus a by 2 multiplied by probability of mu is greater than by 2 plus probability of So probability of minus a by 2 multiplied by probability of my frequency. So this is if this x-axis is my frequency, it is greater than a by 2. If it goes beyond a by 2 also, then there would be error. Similarly, probability of a by 2 multiplied by probability of frequency now less than minus a by 2. So probability of minus a by 2 and probability of a by 2 both are equally probable. So how I can write it? The probability of both of them would be 1 by 2. So 1 by 2 into probability greater than a by 2 multiplied plus 1 by 2 probability. So it is 1 by 2. I take both the probability of minus a by 2 as well as probability of a by 2 to be 1 by 2. So 1 by 2 into probability of mu is greater than a by 2 plus 1 by 2 probability of mu is less than a by 2. So this procedure will follow in the every receiver. So I'll be talking about 4 receivers. I'll be following this procedure only. So I'll just give you simplified expression, a general expression, how I can find out the probability of error. So if I talk about half of the probability greater than a by 2 and half the probability of less than a by 2. So these two are equal because these are equally distributed. So I can say it is probability of shaded region. So the probability of shaded region gives me the probability of error. So I hope you understood how I can find out the probability of error. The probability of error would be the probability of the shaded region. So I denoted it as well. Similarly, I found out what is the amplitude effect on the signal and also the characteristics of the noise. So two things which are affecting my signal. One is the characteristic of the noise and second is the amplitude of the noise. So I'll be talking about these four type of receivers in my upcoming videos. I hope you'll watch those videos for further information. I hope you like this video. If you still have any doubt, you can put your doubt in the comment box and I'll try to resolve it as soon as possible. I hope you like this video. If you like it, share it with your friends, subscribe to the channel and push the like button. Thank you.